Today we are going to start our new topic. The name of the topic is the Laplace transform. We shall discuss about what is a Laplace transform and different rules of Laplace transform for finding out the Laplace transform of various functions. And we will also see the application part of the Laplace transform. Its application will involve to solve a differential equation or a system of differential equation. So let us start. The name of the topic is the Laplace transform. First of all, we must know what is a Laplace transform. We should have a function of a variable t. We should have a function of a variable t. And what is t? T is positive. Either it is equal to 0 or it is greater than 0. Then we can find out the Laplace of this function of t, and it will be equal to integral 0 to infinity e raised to power minus s of t f of t dt. So this will be the Laplace transform of this function of t, and it involves a parameter s. S is a parameter. It may be real, it may be complex. Now you just see, what is this? This is a definite integral with the limits 0 to infinity. It means obviously it will be solved after integrating this with respect to t and substituting the limits of t. Then clearly the resultant of this integral will be a function of this parameter s. And I name it as a function of s. And that function is named as f bar. So we can easily say that Laplace of a function of t is always a function of parameter s. We must remember this definite integral. This is the definition of any function of t and its Laplace transform. Now we have example. We can find out the Laplace transform of 1. You know what is 1? 1 can also be written, it is a function of t, because it can be written as e raised to power 0 t. So by definition, that is equal to 0 to infinity 1 into e raised to power minus s of t dt. We are using f of t as 1. So after integrating it, what will you get? E raised to power minus st upon minus s. The limits are 0 to infinity. What is this? That these are the limits of t. Variable is t here. Minus 1 over s is taken out because it is independent of t. So you can substitute the upper limit infinity, that is the minus infinity. Because when you substitute t as infinity, you will get e raised to power minus s into infinity, that is e raised to power minus infinity. And similarly, for lower limit 0, it will be e raised to power minus 0. What about this? This is a minus 1 by s. It can be written in the denominator, and this is obviously 1. Minus 1 by s, this is a 1 over. E raised to power infinity is always infinity, and 1 over infinity is 0. We all know in mathematics. So this comes out to be 1 by s. So you must know the method to find out the integration of a definite integral. Just see, we have found the integration of this integral, this one, and found that the value of this integral is 1 by s. So this is the Laplace transform of 1. So we must remember this Laplace transformation. This is a standard one. We can also find out the second standard Laplace transformation, that is e raised to power at. And by definition, that is 0 to infinity e raised to power minus st into f of t. What is f of t? E raised to power at into dt, and you can solve this integral minus of s minus a can be written into t dt. You can integrate it minus s minus a into t upon minus s minus a, within the limits 0 to infinity. Now you can write down minus 1 over s minus a and substitute the upper limit infinity in place of t. What will you get? Minus infinity minus. For lower limit 0, what will you get? E raised to power minus 0. Now you just see, this term is similar to this term, and what was its resultant? Its resultant was 0 minus 1. So ultimately we can write down 0 minus 1 in place of this term by using these steps. You can repeat the steps again, and ultimately it come out to be s minus a. Minus can be adjusted with this minus. So what is this? This is the Laplace transformation of e raised to power at. So this is the second formula which we have to remember. Now in the similar way, we can also find out the Laplace transformation of some more formulas. Let us find the third one is Laplace transformation of sine at. Come out to be, this is sine at, that is a upon s square plus a square. So let us find, by definition we will use the definition again as we have used in the previous one, and this come out to be integral 0 to infinity e raised to power minus st into sine of at dt, and we know the formula of its integral. We shall use the formula of 10 plus 2 plus e raised to power ax sine of bx dx. This is the term which we shall use for finding out the integral. What it come out to be after using this? We have to integrate the integrate this integral by using this formula of 10 plus 2 plus, and it can be written as by using the formula, that is e raised to power minus st upon s square plus a square into minus s sine of at plus a cos of at, and the limits are 0 to infinity. And let's see, after solving it, we have to find out this integration. In place of t, we shall substitute the upper limit, and in place of t, we shall use the lower limit also. But it come out to be 1 over s square plus a square can be taken common because it is independent of t. For upper limit, when you will substitute infinity, you will get e raised to power minus infinity and minus, what about this, sine of infinity and cos of infinity will be substituted, and you will use L'Hospital rule and integrate it. How will you integrate it? You will use the formula and find out the value of this integral, this one. What it come out to be? I am straight away going to write the value comes out to be a upon s square plus a square. So you can complete it at the moment because it is very simple to substitute the limits, upper limit as infinity and lower limit as 0. So similarly, we can also find out the Laplace transformation of cos at. That formula is s over s square plus a square. Only change is in the numerator there was a, now there is s. This is the change. On the pattern of these, we can also write down the formula for hyperbolic function, that is sine hyperbolic t. You have to remember these formulas. These are standard formulas, and you must know the proofs how the Laplace transformation come out to be this one of each of these formulas. This one also, you have to prove it at your home task, at your home assignment. This is your home assignment. So a Laplace of sine hyperbolic at is a upon s square minus a square, with the condition s is greater than a of modulus. Similarly, Laplace of cos of hyperbolic at is s upon s square minus a square, with the condition s is greater than a of modulus. Now just see the difference between this formula and this one. Only difference, there is plus sign, there is minus sign. It means in place of sign, there should be a plus sign, but in place of sine hyperbolic, there should be negative sign. Similarly, just see, compare this value with this value. You will see that there is a positive sign, there is a negative sign. So it means in place of, when you have cos of AT, you have a positive sign, and when you have cos hyperbolic AT, you should have negative sign. So this is the easiest way to remember these formulas. So you must remember the proofs of these formulas also. One more standard Laplace transformation is there, that is the Laplace of t raised to power n. It is also very important, t raised to power n, that is n factorial. Formula is n factorial upon s raised to power n plus 1. N should be a positive integer, 1, 2, 3, so. So you must remember the proof of this formula also. Let us prove it. Laplace of t raised to power n, by the definition of Laplace transformation, 0 to infinity, t raised to power minus of st into t raised to power n dt. Now you can use, just see, you can make the adjustment of the terms, but it come out to be, that is e raised to power minus st into t raised to power n dt. For making the integral easier, you can substitute, put s of t is some another variable that can be named as y, but it come out to be s dt is equal to dy. So when you have a lower limit of t as 0, you will see that when you substitute t is 0, you will get the lower limit of y is also 0. And when you put infinity, the value of y is also infinity. And what it come out to be, e raised to power minus y, in place of st, that should be y. In place of t, there should be y over s raised to power n. And what is the dt? That is dy over ds. So the values have been substituted. What it come out to be? If you observe the integral very minutely, you will see that 1 over s raised to power n plus 1 is common. And inside of the integral, there is e raised to power minus y, y raised to power n, dy. And what it is, this is the standard formula. Now you can say that this is the definition of gamma function, which you have studied in probably in first or even second semester. The value of a gamma function is gamma n plus 1, 0 to infinity, e raised to power minus y into y raised to power n. This is the standard definition of a gamma function. This is the symbol for gamma function. So you can substitute the value gamma n plus 1 over s raised to power n plus 1. And what is the value of gamma n plus 1? Gamma n plus 1 is equal equal to n factorial. How? The formula for solving it is, that is n into gamma n, and further that is m into n minus 1 into gamma n minus 1. And when you write it as a so on steps, and then you can write on n, n minus 1, n minus 2, and that should be 3, 2, 1. At last, there should be 1. What is this? This is the value of n factorial. So, in place of gamma n plus 1, you can simply write on n factorial upon s raised to the n plus 1. So, this is the formula which we have to prove of the Laplace transformation of t raised to the n. So, for proving it, you must remember the definition of gamma function. This is the definition of gamma function, and this is the short formula for solving gamma n plus 1. Gamma n plus 1 can be written n gamma n, and for using it again and again, you will write down this term, and this is equal to n. So, this is the proof of Laplace of t raised to the power n. I am going to prove one of the formula of hyperbolic. Sine hyperbolic formula has been written over here, and cos hyperbolic Laplace transformation has been written here. So let us prove one of these. I am going to prove one. You will prove the other as well. Let us prove a Laplace of cos hyperbolic AT, and that is a Laplace of you must know what is the formula of cos hyperbolic. Cos hyperbolic is e raised to power AT plus e raised to power minus AT upon 2. This is the simple expansion or formula of cos hyperbolic AT. 1 over 2 is constant. It can be written out Laplace of e power AT plus Laplace of e power minus AT. And it can be written here 1 by 2. Now, you can use the formulas of these two terms as we have proved in the first previous slides. Just see this one. Laplace transformation of exponential, this one. And that is equal to 1 over s minus 1. S minus e. So whenever there is a positive a, there should be negative a, and if there is a negative a, there should be positive a. So let us use the formula here. This is a positive a, so it can be written 1 over s minus a, and it is a negative a, it can be written s plus a. So easily after solving it, you will see that it come out to be s over s square minus a by taking simple LCM of it. So this is the proof of Laplace of cos hyperbolic a. You can also prove it other way, because higher trigonometric formulas can also be written in many forms. Cos hyperbolic at has been proved. You will prove the formula of sine hyperbolic at also at home. Now, related to the topic of Laplace transformation, we have an important theorem, first shifting theorem. Before this, we shall write on linear property. That is linear property. Linear property is Laplace of C1 f of t plus c2 g of t. It can be written as constant out Laplace of f of t plus constant out Laplace of g of t. This is very simple. What does it mean? Linear property means the constant term will come out of the Laplace transformation, as we have written over here and we have written over here. So you must remember this property also. You can easily prove it by using the definition. Let's see, this is equal to 0 to infinity, and that is e raised to power minus st into function c1 f of t plus c2 g of t dt, and it can be written C1 out 0 to infinity e raised to power minus st f of t dt plus C2 can be taken out because C1, C2 are constants independent of t. That is why it can be written outside of the integral e raised to power minus st g of t dt. And what is this C1 and what is the value of this integral? This is the value of Laplace of f of t and this is the C2 and what is the value of this integral? That is the Laplace of g of t. So this is the simple proof of linear function. Let's see the value. Very simple. Now come to the main theorem, and that is first Schuping theorem. The statement is if Laplace of f of t is obvious, that is always a function of parameter s, then Laplace of Laplace of e raised to power st into f of t can be written as this function has been multiplied with its exponential term e raised to power st. What changes will happen on the right hand side? On the right hand side, it will become f bar s minus a. Constant. So the constant is e, not s. You can take a constant that is e raised to power a. This should be e raised to power at f of t. So on the right hand side, s will be changed to s minus e. So this is the statement of first Schuping theorem. You can easily prove this theorem also. Just see, Laplace of e raised to power at into f of t by definition, that is 0 to infinity e raised to power minus st. That is e raised to power minus st e raised to power at into f of t dt. Now 0 to infinity e raised to power minus s minus a into t dt f of t into dt. Now you just see, if we have this this integral, this one f bar s, you know the definition is 0 to infinity. I'm writing down again e raised to power minus st into f of t dt. What does it mean? If we have the coefficient of t as minus s, then it is equal to function of s. Term is same. Now you compare this integral with this dt is there, ft is there, but only the coefficient of t has been changed. Limits are same. The coefficient of t is minus s and the coefficient of t is minus s minus e. So if the value of this integral is f bar s, so on the same pattern, the value of this integral should be f bar s minus a. Is but obvious. So this is the proof of the theorem. We can easily prove it. This is very simple. So let's see. Go to the example. samples of this group. Suppose we want to solve Laplace of e raised to power t into t square into t square. This is the question we have to find out. It is clear. This is exponential function and this is a polynomial function. And we know that our Laplace of t square, Laplace of t square is equal to, and that is 2 factorial s cube. We shall use this formula for finding out the Laplace transformation. This one, n factorial, if there is t power n, n factorial s raised to power n plus 1. So what is it in our case? In our case, we have a square. So n is 2, 2 factorial over s raised to power 2 plus 1, that is cube. So what about this? By first shifting theorem, that should be equal to, just see the difference between this question and first shifting theorem. In first shifting theorem, that is e raised to power at. If a is there, right side s has been changed to s minus a. If there is a, so in our case, what is a? 1. So it means the right hand side of this term will be changed to s minus 1 whole cube. S minus 1 whole cube. So this is the required Laplace transformation. So with the help of Laplace first shifting theorem, we can easily find out the Laplace transformation of a combination of two functions. First is this one, second is this one. We can also apply first shifting theorem. Like, suppose there is a sine of 2t into t. So there are two functions, sine 2t and t. And we want to apply first shifting theorem. So it can easily be written as, that is, imaginary, easily be written as imaginary part of, you just see, Laplace of e raised to power 2 iota t into t. I have made sine term as exponential term. How? Because e raised to power 2 iota t is always equal to cos 2t plus iota sine 2t. And we have a sine 2t. What is the sine 2t of this term? That is the imaginary part of this term. That's why I have written imaginary part of this. If the question comes for cosine term, then you will write a real part of this term. Just to make the use of first shifting theorem. Because in first shifting theorem, we require an exponential term with a simple function. So now we can find out the Laplace of t. The Laplace of t by using the formula on this pattern, that is 1 factorial upon s square. And that is 1 factorial is 1 as it is, 1 upon s square. So that is equal to, by using the first shifting theorem, what is the coefficient of t? 2 iota. So by using the first shifting theorem, the coefficient of t is a, in place of s can be written as s minus b. So in our question, coefficient of t is 2 iota. So in place of s can be written as s minus 2 iota. And whole square is already there, so you can write on whole square. Now you can rationalize the term, because remember, we require imaginary part, and imaginary part of this term will be the solution of a required question. So s plus 2 iota square and s plus 2 iota square. What will be the denominator term? denominator term will be s square, that will be a minus b and a plus b, that come out to be plus 4 whole square. And in the numerator, there will be s square. The second term will be minus 4 plus, that is 2, sorry, that will be 4. 2ab will be there. That is 4a over s. What should be the imaginary part of this term? That will be equal to, imaginary part means coefficient of a over term. So that come out to be 4s upon s square plus 4 whole square. So this is the required Laplace transformation of this question. So if the question come for a cosine term, Laplace of cos 2t into t, that will be equal to real part, because cos 2t is the real part of this term. The answer will be the real part, that is s square minus 4 upon s square plus 4 whole square. So in this way also we can apply first shifting theorem for solving the Laplace transformation of different kind of questions. So let us proceed further. By using the first shifting theorem, we can write different formulas in this way also. You know that. What is the formula of Laplace of sine bt? The formula of sine bt will be, that is b upon s square plus b square, by using the formulas which we have already written in the previous slide. Just see this one. There is a sine bt, b I have taken in place of a, that is b upon s square plus b square. We have already discussed about this. And, that is the sine bt is b square, b upon s square plus b square. And from this formula, we can derive another formula by using the first shifting theorem. Laplace of e power at into sine bt. Now I am using the exponential term. So first shifting theorem statement is this. If we multiply exponential term with a function, the right hand side, the parameter s will be changed to s minus a. So similarly, we can change the parameter. The coefficient of t is a. So in place of s, we can use s minus a whole square plus b square. So this is another formula of Laplace of e raised to power at sine theta. Similarly, we can also write down the formula for cos term, that is cos bt, that will be equal to s minus a square plus b square. Wherever and whenever we require, we can apply first shifting theorem in various formulas also. For example, we have the formula of t raised to power n, that is n factorial over s raised to power n plus 1. So we can, from this formula, we can also write on Laplace of t raised to power at into t raised to power n. So that will be n factorial over s minus a raised to power n plus 1. So straight away we can also write down the formula by using first shifting. It means this question, this one, can also be done by using this formula. Straight this one. It's very easy to apply first shifting theorem. So you must be able to know what is first shifting theorem and what is the proof of the theorem and how to apply first shifting theorem. I suggest you must practice this and do as many questions your home as you can. Do maximum questions with the help of this theorem as you practice. So there is another theorem, that is the change of scale property. The statement is, if Laplace of f of t is equal to f bar s, then Laplace of f of a t, just see, f was the function of t, now f is the function of a t, that is 1 over a f bar s over a. So this should be the value on the right hand side. So let us prove it. Laplace of f of a t can be written as 0 to infinity e raised to power minus of s t into f of a t dt. For making the integral easier, we shall make a substitution. Put a t is equal to another variable u, a dt is equal to dt. Now, the lower limit of t is 0. You substitute t as 0. The lower limit of u become 0. Only when you substitute t as infinity, the limit of u will be infinity. E raised to power minus s. You can substitute the value of t, and that is u upon a f of u. And the value of dt is du upon a. 1 upon a can be taken out, 0 to infinity. E raised to power minus of s over a into u, f of u du. Now, 1 over a, you know that. What is f bar s? F bar s is integral 0 to infinity e raised to power minus of st f of t dt. So what does it mean? You write f bar s whenever there is a coefficient of t as minus s. So one more thing, change of variable in a definite integral doesn't make any difference. It means either it is the integral with respect to u, or it will be the integral with respect to t. It doesn't make any difference because there are certain limits of this variable, that is 0 to infinity. So what is what is the coefficient of u here? That is minus s over t. So if the coefficient of t is minus s, you write f bar s. So if the coefficient of u is minus s over a, then the value of this integral, this one, will be f bar s by a by this definition. So I am straight away using the definition of Laplace transformation. So this comes out to this. So this is the required term f. So this is the proof of change of scale property. Let us do one or two more questions related to that. Suppose we want to find out the Laplace of sine cube 2t. There is no formula for finding out the Laplace of a cubic term. There is 3 in the power of sine. There is no direct formula. So we have to make a substitution by using the formula of sine 3a. 3 sine a minus 4 sine cube a. Now this cube term can be used over here. So sine cube a can be written that is 3 sine a minus sine 3 a upon 4. So this will be the formula and it will be used here. That is equal to this, what is the angle term? 2t. And here is a. So it means a, the value of a is 2t. So that is 3 sine 2t minus sine 6t upon 4. I have used the formula. 1 over 4 can be written. That is 3 Laplace of sine 2t and Laplace of sine 6t. It is 1 by 4, that is 3 into sine 2t. The Laplace of sine 2t is 2 over s square plus 2 square minus. The Laplace of sine 6t is 6 over s square plus 6 square. Now you can sum up and simplify the term. And what it come out to be? 1 over 4, that is 6 upon s square plus 4, 6 upon s square plus 36. Simplify more by taking the LCM and get the answer. So this is another way of finding out the formula of a term which have cube in the power. Similarly, if we have a question of cos cube 2t, we can also use the formula of cos 3a and find out the formula, find out the solution of the question. So thank you very much. Thank you. That's all for today's lecture.